Hey, just in time for Halloween, we have a mind reader and a spooky storyteller joining us this morning. Tom Britton on the end, Jonathan Pritchard here to talk about an event that'll get you in the mood for Halloween. Now, we have to say this is not for children. The night of storytelling and mind reading.
Right. It's not a children's magic show. This is kind of dealing with folks that may not be around anymore, dining with the dead, that kind of thing.
Yeah, dining with the dead. Yeah. Not for kids.
I would say 16, 17. The fear isn't our language. We're pretty much squeaky clean. We're dressed in our Sunday best for a reason. But some of these stories, well, how do they get to the other side? And you can't, you know, a delicate 12-year-old is crying in the car on the way home, and you're trying to say, no, it's just a fiction, and that 12-year-old's going to be on their phone going, no, Mom, it's based on a real story. That person really met their demise that way, and so I don't know. You know your children better than I do.
Exactly. So we got two shows. We got one tonight and one tomorrow. We'll get to there in a minute, but when people come to the shows, what do they see?
It's a time machine. We're taking you back to the heyday of the seance, mid-1800s to about 1920, especially Detroit, because the Fox Theater and the Vaudeville Circuit were where these performers worked.
Huge impact.
Big. So whether you believe in ghosts or not, we're not here to change your mind or win you over. We're not running for election to the Ghost Congress, right? But in 1870, if you walked in a believer, you walk out a believer. If you walk in a disbeliever, you walk out a disbeliever. What we want to show you is what it would feel like in that experience to transport you. Now you see we're dressed in a modern way. We're not in top hats with twirly mustaches. So we might reference Twitter or the Kardashians, but other than changing that dressing really, the actual meat of what we're doing is unchanged for really hundreds of years, if not thousands, but certainly from the 1800s, 1900s.
Wow, what do we have on the table here?
Right, all sorts of, well, the show is kind of a two-part thing. So he gives you the historical context of what in the world the seance stuff actually is. Right, so we've got the movie background of what we think it was. So he gives the historical context, and then there's the fun stuff. The second half of the show is kind of the interactive part of what people get to experience. So these are some of the kind of things you would get to experience. So I'll let Tom explain.
Also, I wanted to do spooky arts and crafts. So our show isn't for little kids, and I felt bad. So if you're watching moms and dads and kids, here's a fun thing you can do. It's an actual divining tool that was made. Now, you wouldn't use a hex nut and string. Use a skull and a little piece of chain.
Or a metal thing.
Yeah, anything that sort of, and then all you do is try not to move your hand, right? And that's the whole goal, is to not move your hand consciously and just think with your mind back and forth. And try and make that move using only the power of your mind. I am not moving my hand on purpose. As it goes back and forth, you can go in a circle as well. And it feels really spooky when you do it. And then what you would do in the 1700s is a rock on a bit of string, and here's yes, here's no, here's maybe, and now you can talk to those on the other side.
That is crazy.
Isn't that neat?
Right. I'm not moving my hand.
Similar to how a Ouija board would work.
And I'm thinking to myself, yes.
Exactly.
And what's that cost? You probably got one of these in the garage if you want to make the demo version. Or like I said, really, you know, that's a fun little craft project. It's something kind of creepy and spooky.
Whoa. So it's a way of having a conversation with either yourself or somebody that may not be there.
And that feeling you just got, you would have gotten in the 1600s. You would have gotten in the 1500s. You'll get it tonight and tomorrow night at the Hilton Garden Inn. That's what we want to do, is put you in that mindset where you go, oh, if I believed this was haunted, I would be convinced this was haunted right now.
My goodness. Gentlemen, this is going to be a lot of fun. A spook house show tonight and tomorrow, 8 p.m. showtime at the Hilton Garden Inn there in Southfield. You can purchase tickets at WebPlay.
We play.
We play. Thank you very much.
We play.
We play with the dead.com. Easier to read it on the screen than it is on the prompter.
You said, we play with the dead.com.
We play with the dead.com. Gentlemen, thanks so much.
Thank you.
Next on the nine, Lee Thomas.